Let A denote the set of people who like cheese, and let B denote the set of people who like apples. We are given that number of people in set A who like cheese is equal to 63. We are also given that number of people in set B who like apples is equal to 76. Now we know that number of people in the set A union B, or people who like either apples or cheese, is equal to number of people who like apples plus number of people who like cheese minus the number of people who like both. Number of people who like cheese is 63, number of people who like apples is 76, and let us denote by X the number of people who like both, or A intersection B. But number of people in the set A union B, or people who like either apples or cheese, has to be less than or equal to the total population, which is 100. Therefore, 63 plus 76 minus X is less than or equal to 100, or X is greater than or equal to 139 minus 100. And therefore, the number of people who like both cheese and apples is greater than or equal to 39. Let's call this condition 1. Now we note that the set of A intersection B, or people who like both apple and cheese, is a subset of people who like cheese. And similarly, the set A intersection B, or people who like both apples and cheese, is a subset of people who like apples. And therefore, number of people in the set A intersection B is less than or equal to number of people in set A, which is equal to 63. Similarly, number of people in the set A intersection B is less than or equal to number of people in set B, which is equal to 76. Both of these conditions are met when the number of people in the set A intersection B is less than or equal to 63, or X is less than or equal to 63. Let's call this condition 2. From conditions 1 and 2, we conclude that the value of X is greater than or equal to 39 and less than or equal to 63.